What's up? Ian here, and this is my first impression, quick unboxing and graph measurements of the Truthear Hexa 1DD+3BA IEM or earphones. Now, before I begin, I'd like to thank Sunshine Audio for sending this to me and making this video possible. As usual, I appreciate it very much. In fact, I think I owe them a lot. But guys, rest assured that whatever I say in this video is my own opinion. This video is not scripted and Sunshine Audio will be watching this video together with you guys. Okay, so this is the Truthear Hexa. Now, at the time of making this video, it's not available yet. So it will be available on the 11th of November 2022. And the retail price for this is $80. For those of you who are interested, I suggest you camping on their website on that day itself. No, I'm just kidding. So anyway, I will open this up as usual, okay, and then go through the accessories, the fit and comfort. I'll measure this with my measuring rig. I'll go through the specifications. I will listen to this for the first time, and then I'll let you guys know my sound impression of this. But as usual, this is not my full review. I will listen to this for a longer period of time after this video, and then I will come up with another video at a later date. Alright, so this video will be timestamped, so for those of you who want to skip around, please feel free to do so. Okay, right, so let's first remove this plastic. Okay, got my knife here. Okay, so very nice box with the anime girl in front, now holding umbrella. She's got a very cute face, So this is like a waifu thing, so that you know, having a waifu in front of the box. No picture of the IM though, okay. And at the back here you have the name Hexa. Not too sure what this Chinese word means, okay, but it's got a graph. All right, an image of the graph here shows the graph, and I'm going to measure this myself, and then you guys can see later the graph. So this is a 1DD+3BA, and diaphragm is PU plus LCP, and sensitivity is 120, impedance is 20.5 ohms, and the frequency response is 8 to 40,000 hertz. So is this high res? Where's the high res certification? Okay, don't have. Right, so that's the specifications of this. Let's just open this up and see what's inside. Oh, very nice reflective lines here. Okay, and pull tab. Ooh, very unique shape, but let's just take a look at that later. Wow, let's take this out. And so many ear tips. Nothing else. See what's inside this box. Okay, so you have, what's this? Install guide. I don't know what this is. Okay, anyway. Paperwork, let's put them one side. And then you have pouch, nice pouch, cable on the inside. Okay, so let's talk about the pouch first. This feels like leather, okay? It's got embossing of the Truthear logo in front. I think it's leather. Let me do a smell test. Yeah, actually it is. Yeah, it is leather, okay? Smells like real leather. Okay, it's got nice gold buttons here, and it opens like that. So basically it's like a pouch. Okay, you can put your IM inside. It doesn't protect your IM, unfortunately, because it's not a hard case, but it keeps it away from your coins and your keys. Okay, so very nice pouch, very small. Let's take a look at the cable first. Cable, it looks quite familiar. Okay, and I'm not really a fan of this type of cable, okay, to be honest. Yeah, so it doesn't have much body to the cable itself, so it tends to fall onto itself, as you can see, and then I'll then need to untangle it. Okay, so I'm not going to waste time untangling it. So the termination is 3.5 headphone jack. The Y splitter is made of metal, okay, metal sleeve. Okay, metal sleeve, and it's got the Truthear logo here with the chin slider. Okay, and then let me just untangle this. The ear hooks. Ear hooks is kind of soft, okay? I mean, it's somewhere in between soft and hard, okay? So it's not too soft, not too hard, but it's pretty okay. A little bit on the harder side, but later I'll try. Okay, so that's for the cable. Not a fan of this cable. Let's talk about ear tips. So there are 1, 2, 3, 6 pairs of ear tips, okay? And two different types, okay? So three different size. two different types. You have the narrow ball and the wide ball. So the wide ball is for treble, so you want more treble, more dispersion, then use the wide ball. You want more restricted dispersion of the highs and the mids, then use the narrow ball. Okay, and then there's also the foam tips. Okay, foam tips, wow, quite sticky, eh? I mean, if you, yeah, it's quite a sticky foam tip. Okay, and then the ear tip themselves, the silicone ones are pretty okay. The center core is quite stiff, but the flange is somewhere in between soft and hard, lah. Okay, the wider ball one, right, the flange is a little bit softer than the narrow ball one. Okay, so this one I'll try it and let you guys know later. Let's take a look at the IM themselves. And this is a very unique shape. Okay, so yeah, very, very unique shape. I the first time I'm seeing this shape. Okay, very triangular shape, lah. Okay, and then you have a bevel edge here with the Truthear wording here, and this is a screw. Okay, so yeah, very industrial look. It's got a screw on the faceplate. This is the first time I see. I mean, there's another one I saw, which is Allen key, if I'm not wrong. But this is, yeah, a screw. Okay, so faceplate is black, a very simple, clean look. And on the top here, you have your 2-pin connector. On the inside is acrylic. Yeah, it feels like actually plastic or acrylic, I'm not too sure. And it's got this smoked finishing, right? Semi see-through. Can't really see-through, in fact. It's quite blur lah. Can't really see-through. And yeah, ooh, look at the nozzle. This is a very, very unique nozzle. This is my first time seeing this type of nozzle. I've never, ever seen this type of nozzle. Yeah, very, very interesting. Look at the nozzle. And someone please enlighten me what type of nozzle this is. It's got a vent here and then two nozzles sticking out, or two narrow ball sticking out, which I can't really see what, you know, what's inside. But from the side, I can see that, you know, it's like two separate tubes. Very, very interesting. Okay, very, very interesting. Okay, so what I'm going to do now, I'm going to take out my measuring rig and then I'll measure these Hexa. So be right back. Okay, so I am back, and this is the Truthear Hexa, and I've got all my measuring equipment out, my coupler, my usual Yingwu cable, and my ear tips, and my sound card. Okay, so now I've already calibrated everything, so I'm not going to put you guys through that. Okay, let's put the left side into the coupler. Okay, so let's go to the computer and let's measure. Now let's change the name, Truthear Hexa. Okay, so let's check the levels. 86 dB, that's fine. Let's begin, see how this graphs. Okay. Ooh, wow, looks very linear, eh? Very nice. The curve is so nice and, well, I wouldn't say balanced, but okay, never mind. So let's take out the left side and let's put the right side in to the coupler. This is the right side. Okay. Same thing. Make sure the insertion and the depth is the same. Now let's go back to the computer. And then let's measure the right side. First, check the levels. Okay, 87 dB, that's fine, just 1 dB difference. Okay, there's a little bit of channel imbalance. Maybe I'll just do it again. Let's measure one more time. Okay, well, The 8K doesn't really match, so let me just do that again. Okay, let's go. Okay, now the left side don't really match in terms of the let's do this again. Okay, so I think this is the closest I can get, right? It's just a little bit of imbalance is fine. It's less than 1 dB and it's not going to make a lot of difference, lah. Okay, so looking at this, looks pretty linear to me, all right? A very linear graph. There's a very smooth glide from the bass to the lower mids and another smooth glide from the lower mids to the upper mids and to the treble as well. So, and looking at the treble, right, it's got good upper mids, but not as present, but it's got good air and with good extension, lah, okay? Good natural roll-off. So, what I'm going to do now is that I'm going to take out my iPad and then listen to this for the first time. I'm actually quite excited to see or hear this, and let's see how it goes. So be right back. Okay, so I'm back, and as you can see, I brought out my iPad. I've got my usual USB-C dongle from Apple, my usual Yingwoo cable, and of course my usual CP145 spin fit ear tips. Okay, and of course I'll listen to my usual song, which is Golden Hour by Jake. All right, so let's put these in the ear. Let's see how it fits first. Okay, so far the fit is pretty good, doesn't hurt any part of my ear. So but guys, this is just my initial, you know, insertion into my ear, so I have to wear this a bit longer. Okay, right, so now the Truthear Hexa is in my ear. Let's begin listening to the song, and I'll let you guys know what I think and my impression. Let's go. Okay, piano sounds quite natural. The kids and the birds, they sound quite clear, in fact quite forward. Very neutral sounding lead singer. The bass is very light, but it's got that deep tone to it. I can't feel the bass, but it's there. Oh, the air on this is very good. The lead singer sounds really airy, very clean, vocals, very pleasant listening experience. The snapping is very good on this side. The pianos, right, they sound pretty forward, very clear. It's got a very light natural tone. The bass is just nice. You got the impact and you got the sub bass. The rumble is just nice. Very, very good presentation for the sub bass and the mid bass, I would say. Not intrusive at all. It does not bleed at all. Very, very good separation. That rumble and that impact is so precise. It's so good. You know, it's not a grainy. It doesn't sound grainy. Some IEMs, right, they sound grainy during that grumbling side sound. It sounds a bit grainy, but this one doesn't. The violins, they have got a very good air to it, what I feel. Yeah, very nice natural presentation for the violin. Birds are chirping on this side, which is correct. The lead violins on this side, which is correct. Very good sound separation. And that rumble, again, when it comes to this part, rumble comes in. Very low, very good. Okay, let's pause the song. All right. Truthear Hexa, wow, this actually sounds pretty balanced to me, I would say. The tone of this is a little bit on the warm side, the note weight is a little bit on the light side. It's light yet warm. At the same time, it's got that good bass shelf, alright? It's not a heavy bass, it's not too light as well. The impact is also not very impactful, but that's nice. And the lead singer actually sounds forward. Piano sounds natural, sounds forward as well. The imaging and the positioning of the instruments, they are Very correct. In fact, I can actually pinpoint where they are. Soundstage is pretty wide to the sides. It's got good height and good depth as well. There's good layering on this as well. Treble. Treble is actually not the brightest. Okay, it's not the brightest, but it's got a good natural extension of the cymbal strikes. The piano sounds naturally, you know, rolled off, and the birds chirping also sounds pretty natural. Okay, so yeah, that's my very first listen of this Truthear Hexa. Of course, again, this is not my full review. I will listen to this for a bit more, and then a bit later I will come up with another video. Alright, so that's it for now, my very first impression. I hope I entertained you guys and hope you guys enjoyed watching this video, and if you did, please give this video a thumbs up. Alright, so I hope you guys have a great day ahead. I'll see you in my full review of this Truthear Hexa. Cheers.